Hi friends, in the last video we saw some of the features of the VMware vSphere. In this video we can see the other features of VMware vSphere. First we can see about the VMware vRealize Orchestrator. The vRealize Orchestrator is an automation engine which is installed in every instance of the vCenter server. It provides the wide variety of tasks that are available using the vRealize Orchestrator by creating the workflows which are automated. You can create from simple to complex workflows using the vRealize Orchestrator. It also provides the vRealize Orchestrator plugins which extends the functionality of the orchestrator to automate the workflows in the virtualized environment. Next we can see about the vSphere Virtual Symmetric Multiprocessing. It constructs the VMs with the multiple virtual processor cores and or sockets. It also provides the difference between the multiprocessor in the ESXi host system and the multiple virtual processors. And the next feature we can see about the vSphere vMotion and the vSphere Storage vMotion. The vSphere vMotion is the live migration feature that is available for ESXi and the vCenter server, in which it allows you to move a running virtual machine from one physical host to the another ESXi physical host without any downtime. There won't be any network issue or any issue while migrating the one virtual machine from one ESXi host to the another ESXi host. And about the vSphere Storage vMotion is similar to the vSphere vMotion. In this, the storage vMotion, it will move the storage for the running VM between the data stores. That is, the data store of a VM will be migrated to the another data store without any downtime. We can see more about the vSphere vMotion and the vSphere Storage vMotion when we see the live example of the vSphere vMotion and also the vSphere Storage vMotion. Next we can see about the vSphere Distributed Resource Scheduler. The DRS is simply used to extend the vMotion to provide the automatic distribution of resource utilization across the multiple ESXi hosts which are configured in a cluster. Now I will explain how the vSphere DRS works. The ESXi cluster has a combination of CPU power and the memory of the all the hosts in the cluster. It provides the CPU power and the memory based on the usage of the ESXi host. If the VMs in the ESXi host requires more CPU power and memory, it will provide the more CPU power and memory to a particular VM, and if the other VMs in need of the same CPU power and memory, it will split the CPU power and memory between the ESXi host. This is how the DRS works, by distributing the resources equally to all the ESXi host in the cluster. And in the vSphere Storage DRS is same as the vSphere Distributed Resource Scheduler, but here it happens with the storage. The storage capacity and the storage performance is split across the cluster of data stores using the vSphere Storage DRS mechanism. Next we can see about the vSphere High Availability. The vSphere High Availability provides the automatic process for restarting the VMs when the ESXi host faces a time of server failure. If a ESXi host that is connected to the High Availability is in a state of failure, it will restart the VM and provides the backup VM that is available in the ESXi host will be powered on during the server failure. Next we can see about the vSphere Fault Tolerance. It is used to overcome the vSphere High Availability in vSphere high availability, there is a server downtime we can see when using the high availability feature, but in fault tolerance we won't see any server downtime because the fault tolerance provides the mirrored secondary VM in a separate physical host, which is used to back up the virtual machine when there is a failure in the primary VM. Next, we can see about the virtual SAN. The virtual SAN requires at least 3 ESXi hosts, which are also known as nodes, but we can scale up to as many we can need. It also requires the solid state storage in each of the compute nodes to provide the vSAN storage. And last, we can see about the vSphere replication. vSphere replication provides the data replication, which enables the users to replicate the VMs from one vSphere environment to the another vSphere environment. That is, from one data center to another data center, your virtual machines will be replicated from a data center to another data center. So in a time of server failure, you can recover the VM from another data center to make as a primary VM, so there won't be any downtime in it. In this video, we saw the remaining features of the VMware vSphere. Till now, we have seen about all the features that are available in VMware vSphere. In the coming videos, we can see installation and the other features of VMware vSphere one by one. I have published my new Android app in the Google Play Store. I have given the download link of the new Android application in the description. Please download and watch all the technology videos from the mobile app. Please post your suggestions in the comment box and subscribe to my channel for more technology videos. And please press the bell button to get instant notifications on my videos. Thank you for watching.